I'm a little bit overwhelmed, but what's up, guys? Merkeebs here. And I'm here at the Global Sources Consumer Electronics Show in Hong Kong. And I'm over here at the Wuche Studio booth, and sweet keyboard Jesus, I'm a little bit overwhelmed. Wuche Studio invited me over here to cover the event, and they have a lot of cool stuff, and I'll be showing that in a bit, but yeah, it's just a lot.
I'm gonna tour you guys around, and as you can see right behind me, there's like an entire wall of just keyboards upon keyboards, some new release products, some old release products, and just everything from Wuche Studio's lineup. First, starting off, we're here with the Haimu switches. So they aren't labeled, but here is a grand selection of all the available Haimu switches that Wuche are showing off at their booth. And it's an insane amount, and it's kind of overwhelming, low-key. But yeah, taking you guys around, we can see that Wuche Studio has like a bunch of different boards showcased. So this one's a Zoom 75. And then next to it, we have a Promise 87. Next, we have another Zoom 75. And taking you guys around, we can take a look at the keyboard wall. Aside from the keyboard wall, they also have on display pretty much all of their developed keycap sets. Some of them are kind of hard to come by nowadays, but yeah. Checking out the keyboard wall, we can see some of their exclusive, let's say, one-off keyboards. So this one here is a Promise 87. Oh my god, it's heavy. It's made, so unlike the original Promise 87 being made of aluminum, this thing is made entirely of titanium, and trust me when I say it weighs a lot. So yeah, here is a shot of the front of the board, and here's a shot at the gorgeous looking, well, fingerprint covered, wait, and you can see my camera person and in the background. That's just one of their super, super premium one-off boards that they're showing here. Let's showcase their newest keyboard, the Zoom 65 V3 over here. Over here we have the Zoom 65 V3. This is their newest released keyboard. The group I should be coming, I think, around next month, if I remember correctly, and it will have a ton of customizability, a quick detach system, a screen, a knob, pretty much however you want to build it. Even Hall Effect magnetic switches if you want it. So pretty much spoiled for choice when it comes to what you want to do with this board. Here we have a nice little prototype for a Wuche Studio, or sorry, Mellotrix mouse. And the really cool thing about this mouse is wireless, it can do 4 kilohertz, and wired, it can do 8 kilohertz. And only weighs 50 grams, so pretty impressive. The entire setup here, like you see here, the mouse pad, this macro column, and this keyboard aren't running off batteries according to what they said. Everything is charged directly on the mouse pad, so I'm not sure how they're doing it, but basically everything's being charged just directly on the mouse pad. But yeah, Mellotrix are working on a gaming mouse, kind of an ergo shape, similar to like Logitech's G703, if anyone knows that shape. So these right here are the Ava Icky 68 keyboards, and sadly these won't be available internationally because they only managed to get the rights for this in China. But honestly, these are looking pretty awesome. Like, if you're a big Ava fan, these keyboards are a definite cop, because like the level of design work they went into making these is absolutely insane. This one I'm holding is the Asuka colorway, and man, it even comes with like, I'm not sure if it comes like this by default, but these are aluminum keycaps, and this thing weighs a lot too. Like, I feel like it has an internal weight, and they do a lot of theme work for the Ava 2 theming here. It's insane. They built it with split space bars too. And then this next one here is Ava 1, so Shinji's big purple and black themed one. Purple, black, and green, I'm sorry. You can see it comes with also a matching set of aluminum keycaps, and all over the back you can see it says here Nerve. So theming is pretty much on point here all the way through. Here you can see on the side there's even a badge that says AVA 01. Super, super dope looking board. So for those of you that own one of the POS65s, we have the POS65 but now with a Hall Effect PCB if you want a gaming focused POS65 keyboard. And then new to Wuche's lineup is their other sub brand or sister company, Chilkey. And this is gonna be their budget 75% keyboard. And if I remember correctly, it should start somewhere around $100 or less. And it's a 75% keyboard with a quick detach system and the screen. Let me just show this off really quick. So you can see in this gorgeous bright blue, I think I'll be getting a review unit for this soon, but yeah, so far first impressions for a under $100 keyboard, this is absolutely amazing. The anodization quality is insane. Let me see if I can pull this apart. I have to be careful because Uche has informed me that the ribbon cable is a little bit fragile. Okay, yeah, they detached it already, but yeah, you can see it's a quick detach system. And you can pretty much take the board entirely apart. There are a few mounting options, and really it's a great option for a beginner keyboard. So yeah, that's the incoming board from Chilkey. And yeah, I think that's pretty much it for like a general tour. Yeah, that's it. Thanks guys.